Syrian Red Cross, the White Helmets people, they work with our terrorist jihadi. They've been paid for by British intelligence, the CIA, and USAID, which is sort of an adjunct of the CIA. That's been documented if you want to look at it. And they work in cahoots with Obama's terrorist jihadi. So you can't believe anything they're telling you.
Professor of International Law at the University of Illinois College of Law. Francis, I know we had talked about talking for 15 minutes, and we're already way past 15 minutes. Do you still have some time?
Sure. I think this is very important, especially when you have your military personnel over there at U.S. Central Command trying to figure out what's going on here, because, you know, the problem here is that Israel could stage some type of military provocation to set this whole thing off. So they could be a wild card here. Sure, they, you know, they like to take out Syria and Iran together, and they would like us to do their dirty work for them. I mean, they're more than Israel's always been more than happy to have the young men and young women of our armed forces do their dirty work for them, as they did in Iraq 1, Iraq 2. They'd like to do now against Iran. They can't do it on their own. So they like to use our military personnel to do this. So they are a wild card. I don't know what they would do.
What's the end game in Syria? I mean, do you see Russia, Iran, the U.S., Israel all looking vying to take part of Syria's territory and leaving President Assad, the mayor of Damascus? I mean, what's your sense of what's the end game?
I think you're right, Rob. Basically, what we're seeing now, we have seen sort of the de facto cover of Syria, and the President Assad, as you correctly said, is pretty much the mayor of Damascus. This is sort of like the old colonial imperial era, where all the old colonial imperial powers are carving up the region. You have Turkey, the Ottoman Empire, they used to have a slice of Syria there in there.
We're in there. We weren't the imperial power back in those days. The British were there. Remember, France is in there. France was the imperial occupier of Syria after the First World War. And then there's oil. You'll note, Rob, that right now U.S. military forces are occupying the oil fields in Syria with our Kurdish surrogates. We're sitting right on top of their oil. And, of course, Syria is very important for oil pipelines from the Gulf to Europe, and then it could be a jumping-off point for Iran, the final attack on Iran, which Bolton, who is now the new National Security Advisor to President Trump, has called for. Remember, Bolton signed that PNAC report, Project for a New American Century, by all the neocon warmongers, literally, sort of the neocon Mein Kampf, and they came into power under Bush Jr. and, you know, just attacked Afghanistan, destroyed it, and destroyed Iraq. So that's where we are. But I think you're right. It's the imperial karma of Syria going on right now.
I wanted to back
right on. And indeed, if you read the memoirs of General Wesley Clark, after 9/11 2001, he, four-star general commander of NATO, he went to the Pentagon. And the people of the Pentagon told him that there was a plan, a neoconservative plan, to attack about seven Muslim countries in a row. There would be Afghanistan, there would be Iraq, there would be Libya, Syria was on the hit list, Lebanon, Sudan, Iran. And, you know, we have yet to attack Iran. Sudan is, you know, pretty much capitulating to our wishes, so I don't think they're on the list. But Syria was clearly on the list. And Libya was on the list, and Iraq was on the list, Afghanistan was on the list. Lebanon was on the list, Iran's on the list, so there we are. So this has been planned for quite some time.
Are you saying that the U.S. funded these people, or
yeah.
Or was
CIA.
It was the CIA?
Yep.
And how do you know that? How do you know that they funded these?
It's the CIA, and we also got the Saudis to fund them, and the Emiratis and Qatar. Right, that's where all the funding came from. The Pentagon was tasked to arm, equip, supply, and train some of these people. The Pentagon slow walked the whole thing.
Now, are these people the same as ISIS, what we call ISIS over here?
Sure, they're all the same. I mean, you know, they're interchangeable, fungible people one way or the other. I mean, look, Rob, we've been using Islamic fundamentalism that we're arming, equipping, supplying, training, and we've been consistently using these Islamic fundamentalist terrorist jihadis to, you know, accomplish our objectives. This little princeling now from Saudi Arabia, who is just touring our country, and everyone was bootlicking him because he had so much money, stated this publicly just recently on the trip here. He said, yeah, to get our help and money and to spread Wahhabism.
Aren't we fighting ISIS and aren't we fighting the jihadis?
Well, that's what we say we do, but if you look at it, Rob, we let the ISIS people sort of slip out. Whenever we're closing in on them, all of a sudden they slip out and they disappear. This is a pretext to get us back into Iraq, which has now occurred, and to serve as a pretext to get us into Syria. Gives us a toehold in Syria, which we now have, and we are now occupying the oil fields there in Syria. You know, we're over there for their oil in Iraq. Syria is the same, and, you know, we should be taking their oil. You know, President Obama was honest about this, President Trump, where he said, well, you know, we're over there for their oil. And that's correct. That's why we're there. We stand to gain the Syrian oil fields as we see it, and the Iraqi oil fields, as President Trump has admitted, we should take their oil. And that's exactly what we've done in Afghanistan, Central Asian oil and gas supplies. By the way, we're going to be building that oil pipeline from Central Asia down to the Indian Ocean, in Iraq, in the Persian Gulf, Syria, Yemen, and so we're either stealing as much oil and gas as we can, or we are controlling the strategic choke points for the shipment of oil and gas, like off the right there, the Bab el-Mandeb Strait, right off of Yemen, the Straits of Malacca, Syria is a choke point, etc. To go out and steal as much oil and gas as we can all over the world. It's a clash of civilizations. The author of that, Huntington, was the head of the MIT PhD program, and I went through the exact same PhD program at Harvard that produced. As Henry Kissinger said, U.S. foreign policy is not missionary work. And I went through the same PhD program at Harvard that produced Kissinger before me. They even gave me his old office at Harvard's Center for International Affairs. We have used 9/11 2001 as a pretext. We constantly use people like the Kurds. You know, we use them and then we turn on them. And that's the history. And, you know, these people that we use, they're not smart enough to figure that out, that they're being used, or they, you know, they're brainwashed. We had a pipeline where we were funneling weapons, equipment, supplies, and jihadis from Libya to Turkey and then down into Syria. Yeah, I think even Joe Biden admitted that's what was going on when he was vice president. And so as they see it, ISIS is a tool that they can use to overthrow the Assad government, which is the objective here, right?
But if these are people that are acting at our behest, they're certainly killing Americans, killing our allies. They don't seem to be controllable. I mean, they don't seem to be.
That's right. We just sort of unleash them in the general direction we want them to go. they inflict death and destruction along